I also would like to compliment each one of you here and all your colleagues in the Income Tax Department for the diligence with which you carry out your activities, because I'm sure many a times you do face multitude of pressures, right? So to carry on the work with great diligence is something I deeply appreciate and admire. I've been asked to speak to you about the contributions and the positive interventions by the taxpayer to the society, with specific regard to what we do as responsible corporate citizens at Dr. Reddy's. I think it's an apt topic for the occasion, because our corporate social responsibility activities complement all that you do in your role as revenue officers. The founder of our company, my father, Dr. Anji Reddy, he had a very clear vision about our role in the society. He often said, and I quote, "If you point to one single factor that made us what we are today, it is serving the poorest of the poor in the country," unquote. So even when we run the business on a day-to-day, we always remember our role to the society in the way we carry out our business, because we are in the pharmaceutical business, we make medicines and deliver to the people, and we draw inspiration from our founder, Dr. Anji Reddy, who in turn was inspired in his early days by the legendary George Merck. George Merck was the founder of a company called Merck, which is one of the largest and very iconic pharmaceutical companies. And the quote which inspired Dr. Reddy was the following, if I can just read it out to you. Quote, "Medicine is for the people, not for the profits. The profits follow, and if you have remembered that, they have never failed to appear. The better we have remembered it, the larger they have been," unquote. This was from George Merck. And this is what really inspires us when we run the business. So the CSR work, the corporate social responsibility work, which Dr. Reddy's as a company carries out directly, and also through its arm called Dr. Reddy's Foundation, which incidentally, before this whole 2% tax, 2% spend that was mandated to be spent by the companies for CSR, and even much before the term corporate social responsibility itself was in vogue, was something which was being carried out by Dr. Reddy's. Because way back in 1995, Dr. Reddy himself inspired all of us to say that as a company, it's not just the profits that we make or the patients that we serve, it is also about playing a role through active philanthropy in the society. That's something he always encouraged us. And that's how Dr. Reddy's Foundation and Dr. Reddy's as a company was always engaged in philanthropic activities. So our way of approaching this is three-pronged. One is healthcare, the second is education, and the third is in livelihoods, because all these are areas that determine the strength and viability of any society, and for that matter, a nation. So to start with on the healthcare front, I'll be very brief in my remarks in the interest of time. On the healthcare front, one of our flagship programs which we have done is through a partnership with something called NICE Foundation, which also was something which Dr. Reddy himself started. And the program is called CHIP. It stands for Community Health Intervention Program. The results of this program that we did over the last 2 years, and of course this was implemented in the villages around where our manufacturing facilities are located, one in the Srikakulam district in Andhra Pradesh and one in Nalgonda district in Telangana. Almost about 145 villages today are covered, and the benefit goes to almost 2.15 lakh people. And this is something that we do, which acts as a bridge between the needy patients and the government healthcare program. If there was time, I could have explained more about it. But this is a program, for example, of what we started about almost 3 years back. From the company itself, what we had also done, as part of our business activities, keeping in mind the role to the society, especially oncology products, because you know that these are very, very expensive products. These are out of reach of most of the people. They're extremely costly to develop, and ultimately they get highly priced in the market. Through a program which we launched through the business division called Sparsh, and this is not something which was an idea of Dr. Reddy, nor it was the idea of the senior people. It was something which our own people came up with. And this is so that no patient goes without access to a medicine. This Sparsh program make sure that the power is given to the doctor to prescribe the medicine free of cost to the people who can't afford it. This is a program which has been carried out for almost the past 10 years. So these are just a couple of examples in terms of what we do in healthcare. There are many more, but that's something we do. The second part, when it comes to livelihoods, the government of India had identified the need to empower our youth with skill sets to make them more employable and more productive in their work environment. And here you'll find that Dr. Reddy's foundation is in complete synchrony with the government's aims. In fact, it speaks very much of the prescience and the vision of our founder, Dr. Anjali Reddy, that he set up what we call Livelihood Advancement Business School. It's in fact called LABS in short. This was done almost 20 years ago, because this is essentially to equip youth with skills to make them employable. It was as simple an objective as that. And today, LABS has evolved into a more comprehensive program, and it has been renamed as GROW to keep in touch with the reality, because there are several people who now carry out, including government organizations, a lot of skilling programs that are being carried out. And I would say that over the last two decades, GROW has touched the lives of several lakhs of youth and enabled them to secure gainful employment. And in one of the ancillary programs, which I'm extremely proud of, that our organization has taken this up, it's called GROW PWD, for people with disabilities, because this is a problem which goes unrecognized, and it is a serious problem for the country. And our organization, Dr. Reddy's Foundation, has taken this up and has helped hundreds to secure employment, including within Dr. Reddy's laboratories. This is something we have taken up. Also, another related initiative is something called the Mitra as part of the livelihoods, but this is more targeted towards farmers, which enables them to leverage modern technologies and modern methodologies in farming. And almost about 7,500 farmers have been assisted through this program over the years. The last one I talked about was about education. And on this front, we carry out something called School Improvement Program, which is in partnership. This is with the government schools, and most of you must have heard of it. And today, I'm happy to inform that the program has scaled up to almost about 129 schools, both in Andhra Pradesh as well as in Telangana. And it benefits almost 50,000 students, because this is about remedial learning. It's about providing resources so that the schools function better. A whole host of activities, including scholarships to the students. Besides this, again, as a responsibility, the family also has contributed to setting up what is in my father's name called the Kallamanj Reddy Vidyalaya. This was done during his lifetime. And this is a school mostly for underprivileged children. It's on the outskirts of Hyderabad called Chandanagar. And it educates almost 2,000 students at any point of time in the school. It not only includes the school, but also a vocational college, which also gives the youth the skills to also gain employment. So that's something about a school. Not only this, but the family, especially my sister, has been involved in this, has also been involved in setting up neighborhood schools, almost about 20 schools, which educate almost about close to 7,000 students at any point of time. So this is our contribution in terms of education. Again, like I said, there are a whole host of things, but this is just to name a few. Also like to tell you about a little bit of something about our founder, Dr. Anjali Reddy, in terms of what he has sowed the seeds into our organization. And this is called the spirit of giving. You know that he had passed away almost. To get involved in various activities, these include going to schools and teaching students, visiting orphanages, and a whole host of activities which they do. So that's something which we inculcated. So finally, I also must touch upon our contribution to the Income Tax Department itself. Based on a request which came from the department, we designed a program to familiarize newly elected IRS officers with the pharmaceutical business environment, because it is a very complex industry. And this three-day program, which is conducted annually, and the senior leadership of our company takes time out to interact with the young officers and share their perspective and knowledge on the nuances of the pharmaceutical industry and the business environment. This is something which we have been doing. And to conclude, Dr. Reddy's is one of the largest taxpayers in the state, but more importantly, we are always cognizant of our responsibilities to give back to the community from the examples that I've just illustrated. And we will continue to do so in the near future, whether, like Mr. Kumar has suggested, whether there's any tax incentive or there's a change in rule, that doesn't matter to us. We will still keep spending, because we do have a role in wanting to give back to the society. It is our founder who always did this in his personal capacity and through the institutional capacity in which he built up. But more importantly, he inspires all of us, all the 23,000 employees of Dr. Reddy's, to keep doing more and more and be what we call responsible citizens from the company. Right? So thank you. Thank you very much for your attention.